Campaigners are calling for urgent action to tackle anti-Sikh hate crimes, with figures from the Home Office showing a 70% rise in attacks over the last 2 years.
But Britain's first female Sikh MP has warned that those figures may not tell the whole story, arguing a new definition is needed for anti-Sikh hate crimes so the full figures can be collected. Our correspondent Noel Phillips has this report.
Outside Britain's oldest Gurdwara in West London, Dabinderjit and Ramneek are sharing concerns about what they see as an increasing threat against their religion. Both are victims of hate crimes, attacked in the last year for their religious clothing and appearances.
A man came up to me as I was about to cross the road, took a lighter, flicked the lighter, and said various expletives and said, "I burn people like you," pointed to my beard. He moved about a metre closer, flicked the lighter again.
So I'm walking down the high street and I was approached, so I'm wearing my salwar kameez and I was approached by a couple, a man and a woman, and the woman told me really rudely and loudly, "Go back to the country where you come from."
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming to this channel once again. Indeed, there was a time when the United Kingdom was the king of the world, and then it has completely caught into utter destruction. Ladies and gentlemen, United Kingdom, which was the most economic power, has now become one of the most economic ruins. So and so, now they're guarding their fish channels through Navy destroyers and Navy frigates and Navy bombers. So the opportunity is towards Malta. So let's just see what are the conditions that made Malta as the one of the best in the next upcoming future. There was a time when people migrated to US, UK and Europe, but now people are slowly moving towards Malta. And the Maltese government has taken a unique opportunity for all the people who want to come and to provide them the exact amount of jobs and exact amount of salary for the rest of their lives. Ladies and gentlemen, the United Kingdom, which is one of the best nations in the world, provided ample opportunities in 1960s. 1980s, the technology boom has happened. And 1990, because of the falling of the Berlin Wall, IT jobs poured into the United Kingdom. But 2020, all those have been gone, obliterated and completely omitted from the map of this world. Now, there is only one job, which is NHS, or the nurses, or health services. On the other hand, the non-skilled category, semi-skilled category, and skilled category jobs are all under the Maltese belt. 1960, there was nothing or no jobs for anyone, even for the Maltese citizens. Whereas in 1980, there was no jobs for foreigners. In 2018, the workers in demand risen too much, and 2021, it is going very much and it's going ample as the time passes on. So, what just the non-skilled category jobs are there? The non-skilled category jobs are into the toilet cleaner, newspaper delivery, labor jobs, metal worker, packer, assistant cook, bartender, childcare, fast food workers, kitchen helpers, and receptionist. All these jobs and all are with this particular salary scale, which you can see on the screen right now. However, the real data is available with link in the description below from where you can search by yourself as well. Furthermore, the documentation part for the non-skilled workers are similarly very less. It is a letter of invitation from the employer where they want to work, supporting documents for the visit, that why are you visiting to that Malta, organized trip and a valid return ticket, certificate of reserved prepared journey and valid passport. With that, if any non-skilled worker wants to go to Malta, they all are definitely welcome. Now let's just see about the skilled worker and who is a skilled worker. Skilled worker, which means an independently guy who can work without any guidance. Now, what we think that skilled worker is all about who can know about computers. But in reality, the skilled worker who knows something on their hands or who has an hands-on experience. What we think that skilled worker who is a manager or management position and who can delegate the projects, but according to the world, skilled worker means who has actually gained some hands-on experience, who has some YouTube videos, who has his particular website, who has a particular social media, who has a collaborator under her or under his belt of an international level, who knows exactly where to pin upon and how many magazines or how many journals he has written. Because when the skill category comes in, the salaries are this much high. That's right. All these salaries of artificial intelligence engineer, artificial intelligence programmer, machine learning engineer, machine learning specialist, data scientist, data wrangler, cloud security, cloud native, self-service business intelligence, cybersecurity, web developer, wind turbine, and nuclear engineer. You can very much see on the screen that all these specialists and engineers and programmers have international collaboration, and they have developed their own product. They have developed their own niche where they can show to the entire world that what they are made of. So just working for some company and gaining some experience for 6, 7, or 8, that doesn't qualify any person to be a skilled worker. A person who has developed his product while working and is also enrolled into future development for a lifelong learner, those are skilled workers category. Now let's just see what are the documents required. The documents required for the skilled categories are similarly the same. That is the letter of invitation, supporting documents for the visit, organized trip, and a specifically work experience certificate or any websites or the YouTube videos which shows that they are the skilled worker, and a valid passport always. Now we see what are the semi-skilled workers, and the semi-skilled workers are the people who are actually the man or the woman behind the skilled workers force, those who are the actual lab technicians, laboratory workers, construction laborers, or fitters or welders, those who have created the entire structure. So if we see the semi-skilled worker salary, the chemical lab technician, machine operator, design technician, electrical technician, ASP.NET, Android developer, CNC programmer, fitter, milling machine operator, goldsmith, housekeeping, petrol station worker, and foreman, all the salaries are laid out in front of you. And you can see that all of them have a salary scale more than 1,500 in a general. And more than 1,500 euro is enough for any person to survive in Malta, as we have already made a video on the basic utilities and If you have not, then I'll paste the link below on the description. So you can see that the semi-skilled workers are the backbone to the industry. And company do require semi-skilled workers and the skilled workers, but there's also demand for non-skilled workers for the general people. And the salaries are equally distributed, as you can see it in here. So what are the documents required? The documents required is a letter of invitation, a supporting documents for the visit, an organized trip or a valid return ticket, work experience certificates, and valid passport. A quick recap, and for the non-skilled worker, semi-skilled worker, and skilled worker, is that for the salary scale that is ranging between the non-skilled, semi-skilled, and skilled, the non-skilled are from 679 euro to 876 euro. Semi-skilled workers are 1,701 euro to 1,905 euro. The skilled workers are 5,451 euro to 7,325 euro. But guys or girls, this is not the fixed. This is not the mandatory. As we are living in a dynamic world, we are living in a changing world, we are living in a different scenario, different universe, everything is achievable. If a non-skilled worker get enough training or get enough education or get enough hand-skilled work, they can convert their salary from this to the semi-skilled structure. And similarly, if a semi-skilled worker work hard enough, made connections in Malta, they can definitely migrate to any other European nation, as because Malta is a Schengen region, and once you are in Malta, you can visit to any other Schengen region in Europe. You can convert yourself from semi-skilled salary from 1,700 to 5,451 euro. And I'm telling you, Germany, Sweden, Belgium, Netherlands, they look the workers who are coming from semi-skilled, and they always like to hire. So friends, this is all about for the salary scale of the workers under semi-skilled, skilled, and non-skilled workers. And how IU can help you? IU can help you in many of the opportunities. We can help you to get the jobs through arranged employment. We can help you to get the documentations ready. We can help you while filing the work permit. And once it's done, the DHL courier with the further visa processing to the post-landing services and get you settled inside the Malta. Ladies and gentlemen, Malta is going to be the next biggest opportunity for the future. And if you are into or planning to go to Malta, this is the best time. Thank you for being in here. Thank you for liking this video. Please don't forget to subscribe and share this video. I'll see you in the next one.